is at that point that, to me, what a volunteer is about is reaching out. It is reaching out. And we do that in different ways. For me, it started when I went to Trinidad in the West Indies. I spent 2 years there in the... Is there anybody here from Trinidad? Good. This is good. So I went there when I was 19 for 2 years with an organization called CUSO. I went to work with the YMCA. I was making $10 a week, plus room and board. That was a lot of money back then, to believe it or not. And after I'd been there a month, the head of the YMCA went back to England, and I was made the head of the YMCA of Port of Spain, Trinidad. I was 19. I knew very little. Well, after about a month, they said, we need to raise some money. Now, I know a lot about fundraising now because I ran the United Way and was vice president of a couple of universities. But I didn't know a lot about raising money then, and I've heard tonight about fund development for fame. So I'm going to suggest an idea to you. So I thought about it, and I thought, when I was 17, growing up in North Toronto, we used to sell Christmas trees for the YMCA. And through this brilliant idea, I thought if we sold Canadian Christmas trees in Trinidad, there'd be no competition. I convinced the board of directors of the YMCA of Port of Spain, Trinidad, to order 1,500 Scots pine trees from the YMCA in St. John, New Brunswick, and put them on a ship down in the cargo hold, nice and cool, and they'd arrive fresh. Well, I got our young people involved, because you get people involved, and they went to the Canadian High Commission and the U.S. Embassy. They got the list of all Canadians and Americans living in Trinidad, and they went out and pre-sold 1,200 trees. I was looking pretty good. There was an article in the newspaper. My name was in it. I sent it home to my mother. My mother shared it with the Bridge Club. She was very proud of her son. Everything was going great. And December the 15th, the trees were to arrive, and they didn't. Whew. I made a long-distance call. I said, where are our trees? They said, oh, Mr. Cressy, we're terribly sorry. We should have called you. There was a fire on the ship. I said, oh, no. They said, good news. I said, what could be good? They said, we saved the trees. I said, well, where are they? They said, we put them on another ship, and they're coming down, and they should get there about December the 21st. I said, whoa, that's really close. They said, well, call Bermuda, see how the ship's doing. I put another long-distance call into Bermuda to discover that there was a dock workers' strike in Bermuda. They hoped it would clear in a few days, and if all was well, the trees would arrive on December the 27th. There was an emergency meeting of the board of directors of the YMCA in which they put forward this motion to send this young Canadian volunteer home. It is at this point you need to adapt and adjust quickly with a good sense of humor. So I suggested that for that year only, we would have Christmas in Trinidad on December the 30th. This idea did not go over very well. And the next morning, two of the people on our board and myself went down to BWIA, British West Indian Airways, and suggested to them a wonderful marketing opportunity in which they would give us an airplane free of charge. We would take all the seats out of the airplane. We would fly the airplane to Grantley Adams Airport in Barbados. We would get the trees off the ship, put them on some trucks, drive the trucks out to the airport, take the trees off the trucks, and put them on the airplane, and fly back to Trinidad and get them all ready to be sold. Lo and behold, they agreed. Headline, Trinidad Guardian newspaper, Christmas tree airlift to raise funds for local YMCA. And on Sunday, December the 22nd, two of us, two stewardesses, 10 bottles of Old Oak Trinidad rum, which is a very fine rum, flew to Barbados, arriving all intact, got down to the docks to discover, we'd forgotten completely, it was Sunday, and the dock workers weren't working. But many of them were around, and 8 bottles later of Trinidad rum, they were working. And the trees came off the ship onto the docks. We put them on the trucks. We drove the trucks out to the airport. We took the trees off the trucks. We put them on the airplane. And two of us, two stewardesses on top of 1,500 Scotch pine trees, flew back to Trinidad, arriving all intact at Piarco Airport, took the trees off the plane, put them on the trucks, drove down into Port of Spain, arrived at the YMCA Christmas carols, and in 48 hours, we sold out all the trees, made a profit of $8,000 for the local YMCA, and on December the 28th, the Trinidad government banned Canadian Christmas trees, asking people to grow local trees, and we spawned a little cottage industry that exists to this day. Now, I thought that was the whole story, but there's a tiny part more, because about 4 years ago, this fellow in his 40s came to me and he said, "You taught me how to swim at the YMCA. Here's a picture." And I said, "Oh, gee, that's right." I said, "Come to our house at Christmas time. We sing Christmas carols, and I tell the Christmas tree story now for the 18th time, much to my wife's chagrin, I might add." So I told the story, and this young fellow got up and he said, "There's another part to the story." And I said, "What was that?" He said, "Well, two of us were helping sell the trees, actually threw 20 of the trees over the back fence, went down on the corner, and we sold them ourselves and made $200 ourselves." Was the entrepreneurial spirit. And then about 2 years ago, there's a fellow, Stuart McLean, who many of you were at a show called The Vinyl Cafe, and he said, "It's the 40th anniversary of CUSO, and we heard about this Christmas tree stuff. Is that true?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Could I put it on the radio?" And I said, "Fine." So he did. And then I got a call that night from somebody in BC. And he said, "Is that a true story about those Christmas trees?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Well, I'm a movie producer." I said, "Oh, yes. I did The Beachcombers and this and that." He said, "Did you ever see the movie Cool Runnings with John Candy about the Jamaican bobsled team?" I said, "Yes, that was very funny." He said, "This is the same movie in reverse." So I was figuring out who'd be the star, Tom Cruise or something very exciting like that. My wife said to me, who's very smart, she says, "You've built your whole life on one story. The movie will never get off the ground." And it hasn't. But if it does, I want you to know about it all. Now, when I used to chair the board of the Toronto Board of Education, I talked to our principals and I said, "Get involved in the community." They didn't know what I was talking about back then, but somebody got it. One of them decided he would go around the corner to the senior citizens' home, and he went there and he said, "What do you think of us? We're your neighbor." And the head of the senior citizens' home said, "We don't like you." "Why?" "Well, your kids stomp on the grass, their language is bad." And then he said the magic words. And these are the magic words: "What can I do to help?" You're amazed if you use that line. Someone's really angry at you, stop, take a deep breath, and say, "What can I do to help?"